Good morning to everyone and welcome to ERS-CAM, the channel that gives you current updates and important news. I am your host, Ethan, to give you the latest. Our most important headline for today is Super Typhoon Yolanda, or known internationally as Haiyan. Typhoon Yolanda has made landfall in eastern Visayas, threatening areas in its path, according to our Weather Bureau Pagasa. Super Typhoon Yolanda smashed into the central island of Samar early on Friday morning, packing sustained winds of up to 315 kilometers per hour. Yolanda made its landfall over eastern Samar at 4:40 a.m. It made a second landfall over Tolosa, Leyte, at 7 a.m. Here's a satellite image from Pagasa of Typhoon Yolanda at 4:30 a.m. November 8, 2013. In Tacloban City, Leyte, a city very near the site where Typhoon Yolanda first made landfall, flood water quickly rose, and video footage showed debris on the road swept by flood waters. Visibility was also poor due to the strength of the typhoon wind. More areas have been placed under public storm warning signal number 4, where winds of at least 185 kilometers per hour may be felt in at least 12 hours. Let me turn you over to Pagasa for updates on different areas. Good afternoon, this is Mr. Santos from Pagasa. Here are the areas under signal number 4 are Masbate, Tikau Island, Southern Sorsogon, Romblon, Northern Samar, Eastern Samar, Samar, Leyte, Southern Leyte, Biliran, Northern Cebu, Cebu City, Bantayan, and Camotes Island. Under signal number 3 are Burias Island, Albay, Marinduque, Occidental Mindoro, Oriental Mindoro, Calamitan group of islands, the rest of Sorsogon, the rest of Negros Occidental, and Negros Oriental. Catanduanes, Camarines Sur, Southern Quezon, Laguna, Batangas, Rizal, Metro Manila, Cavite, Bataan, Lubang Island, Siquijor, Northern Palawan, Puerto Princesa have been placed under signal number 2. Thank you, Mr. Santos. More than 125,000 people in the most vulnerable areas have been moved to evacuation centers before Yolanda hit, according to the Civil Defense Office, and millions of others braced for the typhoon in their homes. Authorities said schools in the storm's path were closed, ferry services suspended, and fishermen ordered to secure their vessels. The president also warned areas within the expected 600-kilometer typhoon front would be exposed to severe flooding as well as devastating wind, while coastal areas may see waves 6 meters high. But despite all these, a lot were damaged and we lost a lot of lives because of storm surge. The incredible intensity of Yolanda drives a huge storm surge which crashed over the coastline. This is the first time this happened in the Philippines, and we are not prepared for something like this. Let me turn you over to Gabrielle from Tacloban for some updates. Hi Gabrielle, how are things doing over there?
Good morning to all. I am now here in Tacloban City where Super Typhoon Yolanda made its landfall. The sight here is devastating and heartbreaking. Catastrophe everywhere. According to the people here, the flood water became 20 feet deep. In just minutes, everything here just floated. Let's go and interview some residents.
Look at the damage and look what's happened there. I can't imagine.
Good morning. Can you explain or share to us what happened here when the storm arrived?
A few rains, and even when we were already signal number 4, very fine weather. So I was so surprised. I was even telling myself and my kids that it's okay to have signal number 4. We started to pack our things. We buy plastics, cellophanes, big cellophane, plastic cellophanes, and then we put the books, our TV, we cover it with cellophane.
I was so scared, praying to the heavens, saying, please stop this rain. 5 a.m., our house was destroyed.
This was where we hid after our house collapsed. We stayed right here. I crouched over all of them. I called their names. I said, Sarah, take care of Precious, her baby. Over here was Crystal and Liza. There was Jamaica, Marie-Faye, Aaron, and Angel. I huddled them together. I told them, get up, up, water. And just like that, the water rose to my chest. It was not a normal flood from rainwater, but a wave coming in from the shore. It was so sudden. It was at my ankles, then suddenly up to my chest, and the next wave brought the water up to my neck until I was completely submerged.
We instructed our patients to get out of their rooms and to slowly to be on the basement where we think at that time was safe for us. We place our patients here only with their IV, with their intravenous fluids. So here, they pile up here. Clear, here only, clear water. Then after that, we see the surge, the wind, and the flood, which was up to here, that was thick as the color was black. Blackish water was coming at the second floor to get up, so that we will be safe.
But I could not go down anymore because of the water was rising up here. So that's the thing. It's either the water or the wind. It's almost like the devil and the deep blue sea. We never consider the storm surge and the destruction that it will bring us.
They were in panic. Everything floated like a paper. The refrigerator, the divider, the flat screen TV, and everything. It floated like a paper.
There you have it. Let's all pray for the people affected by this disaster. Thank you, and this is Gabrielle reporting from Tacloban City. Back to you, Ethan.
Thank you, Gabrielle, for the update, and we are truly sorry to see and hear about the situation there in Tacloban. According to experts, the storm alone did not cause the fatal blow in Tacloban. It's the storm surge. Philippines is used to having storms, but we never experienced storm surge until now. Let us listen again to Mr. Santos from Pagasa. He will explain to us further how storm surge happens. Thank you, Ethan. Just to give you an insight.
A storm surge begins when wind pushes water across the surface of the ocean. That displacement pulls more water upward from below. If the storm maintains its strength, the continuing churn sets up a vertical circulation and underwater wave. The warmer the water, the larger the storm, the faster the winds, the bigger the wave as it approaches land, and the water becomes shallower. The wave bulges upward, causing sea level to rise.
This is exactly what happened to Tacloban. Plus, the position of Tacloban also contributed to the disaster.
The city happens to sit inside a relatively shallow protected bay. As the surge approaches, the shallow offshore terrain pushes the water up. And at the same time, the narrow confines of the bay squeeze the water, causing it to rise even further.
Thank you, Mr. Santos. Now we understand better. So that's how it happened. No wonder no one was prepared. What happened in Tacloban brought about by Super Typhoon Yolanda is really heartbreaking. Let us all help in any way we can, and let's pray for them. You may send donations via Gcash to 0915-0956123 or BPI number 123456789-0. Thank you. This is Ethan, and see you again tomorrow for another ERS-CAM news update.